Hi, I welcome you in this amazing session of Python Pandas. We will understand all these topics of pandas. I request you to watch this tutorial completely. Okay, so you will understand pandas operations of data analysis very easily by using practical methods and as well as theoretical study notes. As you can see, I've created very amazing study notes only for you. So please subscribe to our channel and you can also access our Python programming videos that are given in the description of this video. Okay, so please subscribe and also share it with your friends so they can also benefit from our videos. Okay, so let's start our pandas learning journey. First of all, what is data analysis? So data analysis is a process that is used for cleaning, transforming and modeling data to discover useful information, and that useful information is used in business decision making. As you know, data is collected from our phones, from computers, from internet. Okay, so that data contains very useful information. So there is a vast data, but from that huge or vast data we apply data analysis methods. So by using these methods we extract information from the data and we use that information for making business decisions, right? Business decisions means the companies that use that information for serving us greater applications, best content or any product that the company make. Okay, so we use Pandas library for data analysis. Pandas is a very popular data analysis library. We will understand all the topics of data analysis, data manipulation in this tutorial. Just stay connected. Okay, so what is Pandas? Pandas is a very fast, powerful and easy to use open source library. Open source means its code is freely available. Pandas is freely available to everyone. So Pandas is very fast and very powerful and very easy. So who developed Pandas? Wes McKinney developed Pandas in 2008. For working with Pandas, our computer must have Python IDLE installed. You can install Python IDLE just visiting our website topperg.com, as you can see on the screen, topperg.com. And after visiting the website, in the search bar, you can search for Python IDLE. You can download it and you can install it in your computer very easily. Okay, after installing Python IDLE, you have to install Pandas library. For installing Pandas library, you have to open command prompt. As you can see, you can search command prompt in your search bar of your computer. Open command prompt and here you have to write pip install pandas. Okay, press enter and your computer must be connected with the internet. Pandas will be installed. Okay, after installing pandas in the Python IDLE in programming, you can import pandas library but like this, import pandas, and you can give it a short name pd. Pd name will be used to access the functions of pandas. So what is pandas? It is a library. It is a collection of functions that we will use to analyze data, to manipulate data. Okay, so let's start. For data analysis, we use data structures, right? What is a data structure? A data structure is a collection of data. So in a data structure, data is stored and organized so that we can easily access and modify or manipulate the data. Okay, so Pandas has two data structures, series and data frame. What is a series? A series is a one dimensional data structure. It means a series is a collection of data in one dimensional format. One dimensional means you can understand it like a column in a MS Excel sheet. Okay, so in a series we can store any type of data like integer, string, float, Python objects. I have told this data types or the working of these data types, function of these data types in our tutorials that are given in the description. Okay, you can understand all these data types, working of these data types, integer, string, float, like list function, list manipulation, tuple, dictionary. Okay, just watch our lecture. Its name is Python Revision Tour 2. Okay, it is given in the description. So now you have understood what is a series. Okay, what is a data frame? A data frame is like a collection of series. Okay, a data frame is like a spreadsheet, two-dimensional data structure. So how we can create our series and data frame? Let's first understand our series. So this is, you can see our series. 4, 5, 6, 7 are the values. As I have already told you, a series is a one-dimensional data structure. It means a series is like a column. It has only one column, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 0, 1, 2, 3, these are the indexes of column values. So this series has 4 rows and 1 column. And 0, 1, 2, 3 are the indexes of rows. Okay. So how we can create our series? Import pandas. Okay. Create a list. Apply series function. S must be capital. And put the list in the series function. Series will be created in SX. You can print it. Okay. So this will be the output. Let me show you. As you can see, the output series has been created. Right. So we can use like list, tuple or dictionary to create our series. Here I can put a tuple or dictionary. As you can see, I have put a dictionary here. I have created the series by using a dictionary. This dictionary has three values and three keys. 45, 78, 67 are the values. 1, 4 and 2 are the indexes or the keys. So as you can see, output of the dictionary 45, 78, 67, 1, 4, 2. Okay. These are 1, 4, 2 are the indexes of rows. A series has always only one column. Creating data frame. How we can create a data frame? As I have already told you, a data frame is a collection of series or a collection of rows and columns. So here I have created three series and I have created series directly by putting a list in series function directly. Okay, I have created three series and these three series I have put them in a dictionary. Okay, so data frame will be created. This is the function data frame. Okay, PD, it is the short name of the pandas library. So let's check its output. Okay, so NaN is shown here because the last value of this series is not available. These two series has four values and it has three values. Okay, so in that case, a value will be auto created and this is NaN. It means absence of value, no value. Okay, so if I take a value here and then check the output, you can see the output. Okay, now you have understood how we can create a series and how we can create data frames. So now we must understand how we can use head and tail functions in series and data frame. First, we will understand how we will use head and tail functions in series. Okay, so I have created a series here. This series has how many rows? Total 6 rows. So what is the work of head function in series? I have applied head function in our series X and it will return some value and we will print it. Okay. So head function gives me the top values. Okay. So in that case, H will get top 5 rows of the series because I have not given any argument. If I don't give any argument, head function will return top 5 rows. Okay. As you can see, 5, 6, 7, 6, 5. If I give an argument, suppose 3, then it will give me top 3 rows. Okay. If I give negative value, it means that it will remove 3 values from the bottom and will return me the remaining rows. Okay. From the top. 5, 6, 7. Okay. If I give here like minus 4. So it will remove 4 rows from the bottom and will return me top remaining values. 5 and 6. Okay, it is very easy. So now let's understand tail function in series. So if I don't give any argument in tail function, it will return me last 5 rows. Okay, I've changed the name of the variable. So as you can see, last 5 rows, 6, 7, 6, 5, 4. 6, 7, 6, 5, 4. If I give an argument, then it will give me last 3 rows, 6, 5, 4. If I give negative argument here, suppose minus 2, then it will remove 2 rows from the top and will give me remaining rows, 7, 6, 5, 4. Okay, so now you have understood how we can use head and tail functions in series. So now let's understand these functions in data frame. So what is this? A data frame has been created directly. I've created a dictionary of two series X and Y. These are the two series. Okay, so this series have how many values? You can count total 7 values. Okay, so first let us check the output of our data frame. I've created this line a comment. Okay, so it will not be executed with the program. You can create any line comment by putting hash before the line. So let's check its output. Okay, so this data frame have 2 columns and 7 rows. Okay, so now let's apply head function. If I don't give any argument in head function, then what will happen? Top 5 rows will be returned. Okay, as you can see, if I give an argument, then it will return me top 3 rows or any number of rows that I provide. If I give negative, then it will remove these number of rows from the bottom. I've provided here -3, then it will remove 3 rows from the bottom and will return me all the remaining rows. Similarly, tail function, if I don't give any argument, then it will return me last 5 rows. Okay, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 indexes you can see here. And if I give a negative argument, then it will remove these number of rows from the top and will return me the remaining rows. So top 4 rows will be removed. Okay, 0, 1, 2, 3. These rows are removed. Index 0, 1, 2, 3 rows are removed and remaining rows are returned. Okay, if I give a positive argument, then it will give me last 3 rows. So you have understood how we can apply head and tail function in series and data frame. There is a very important concept. You must understand how we can create data frame. In how many ways we can create data frame. Because if I show you this program, can you predict the output without executing it? It is very important to understand this. Okay, so you can easily predict the output if you can predict the output of data frame. If you can predict by just watching these lines, okay, if you know how a data frame is created, how many rows and columns will the data frame consist, you can easily predict the output. If I ask you a question, how many rows or columns will this data frame, its name is that, how many rows and columns will this data frame contain? Can you predict it? Can you tell me? So it is very easy. Okay, if I am creating the data frame, if I am creating a data frame using list, okay, then you can remember it, list item will be called rows. So I have created this data frame by using list. It has 2 variables. 2 variables are dictionary. So all the values of dictionary will serve me as a row. So you can easily tell this data frame will have 2 rows and how many columns? 4 columns by just watching the values of the given variables. Okay, if the data frame is created by using dictionary, then its items will be used as columns. So this data frame is created by using dictionary, so its items will be used as columns. X will be used as a column, Y will be used as a column. 3, 6, 8, 9, 5, 7, 8, 2. These are the column values. Here, as you can see, a data frame is created by using dictionary, so its values, its items will be used as a column. Here you can see a data frame is created by using list. So list item will be used as a row. So you can just remember it by using this. DICLIR. Dictionary items are columns, list items are rows. If you just need to understand how you can easily predict the output of data frame. If you can predict the output of data frame, you can easily predict any function output. If I apply head function, if I apply head tail function with any value, you can easily tell me what will be shown in the output, because I have told you a very good method of prediction. So now let's understand data frame manipulation. in the structure of data frame, how we can create manipulation. How will I add a new column in a data frame? Suppose a data frame is created here directly, and this data frame is created by using list. Okay, by using list. So list item will be used as rows. So just by watching this, I can tell you this data frame will have two rows. Want to see? I can show you. This data frame will have two rows and five columns. Let us check. Okay, how I know? Because I have told you a shortcut. Data frame items are columns, list items are rows. Okay, so how will I add a new column in this data frame? Simply use a data frame name, take the index of a column. You can take any index. I have taken a string A and I have given it some values. So you must remember, you must understand how many values you can give while creating a new column. Before giving the values, you must understand, you must predict the output of the data frame. I have told you this data frame will have two rows and five columns. It means one column has two values. So while I am creating a new column, it means while creating a new column, I need to give two values in this data frame. Okay, don't make any mistake. You must understand this topic, right? So let's check its output. Let's check. So this is our column A, 9 and 7. Okay, it is auto created. Now let's check it again. Okay, column A. I can take any name. I already know this data frame will have two rows and five columns. I am adding a new column, so I can give it a index 5, because indexing start from 0. So the new index will be added 5. Okay, 9 and 7. So now you know how you can add a new column. Okay, so here as you can see, I added a new column by using list, right? Only thing that you must know, how many rows and column the data frame consist. On if you know that, you can easily do any manipulation, right? So here I have created the data frame by using dictionary. It means D1 will be a column and D2 will be the second column, right? And here I am adding a new column, column C. I know D1 is a column, D2 is second column. It means this data frame will have two columns and three rows, right? So I am adding a new column. It means I need to give three rows values. Let's check it. Okay, one thing that you can remember, I am creating this data frame by using dictionaries, and in these dictionaries, okay, the rows name, you have to put these rows name same. Okay, as you can see in the output, the rows name A, B and C are same. Let's check if I give a different index. You already know it is first column, it is second column. Column name is A, column name is B. So rows indexes will be A, B and C, A, Z and C. I have already told you rows indexes must be same. But if I give a different row index, what will happen? Error will occur. Okay, so rows index must be same, right? If you are creating a data frame by using dictionaries, it is a very simple, it is common sense. Okay, you know that these values will be column 1, this is column 2. So column 1 will have 3 rows. So what will be the index? It will be A, B and C. So it is common sense to provide the same indexes in the next dictionary. Okay, so how can I give column names while creating a data frame? Just import pandas D1 and D2. What is this? These are the two lists. I have created this data frame by using list. So it means D1 will be a row and D2 will be second row. Okay, it is first row, it is second row. It means this data frame will have three columns. So I need to provide three column names. You can easily give it like this by putting comma in the data frame after providing the data and columns equals to, and you can create the name of list. Name of list means name of columns, indexes. Okay, how I can change column names? How? Just create a data frame. This data frame will have How many rows and how many columns? Can you tell me? Two rows. Okay. This is row 1. This is row 2. So it is very easy to predict. This data frame will have 3 columns. So I need to give 3 column names. Here I gave column names while creating data frame. But after creating the data frame, I can also change the column names like this. Data frame name columns by using dot notation and give it a list. Let's check it. Okay, column names are changed. So if we are using dictionary for creating data frame, then we don't need to provide column names using columns. So it is very easy. If I am putting a dictionary here, then I don't need to give columns, right? Because while creating a dictionary, the indexes of items are used as column names, right? How can I delete a column? First, create a data frame, okay? And after creating the data frame, you can use the word DEL, take the data frame name and take any column name you want, okay? C. How you know its name will be C? Just simply predict the output of data frame. This data frame will have two rows. Two rows means two rows, D1 row, D2 row. So this data frame will have 3 columns. So column C, column B and column A. And I have deleted here column C. Now let's understand row manipulation. Can you tell me how many rows and columns will this data frame have? This data frame have been created by using a list. Okay. So list item 1, list item 2, list item 3. Okay. So this data frame will consist 3 rows and 2 columns. Okay. 3 rows and 2 columns, as you can see the output. So how can I add a new row in a data frame? Just take the index. Okay. I have created this data frame by using list. So no index like dictionary is used. So index will be by default, index will start from 0. This data frame will have 3 rows and 2 columns. So rows index will be 0, 1 and 2, 3 rows. Okay. So for adding a new row, I can use this word data frame name and then dot loc and then give a new index of the row and give row values. I know that a row contain 2 values. Okay. A row has 2 columns. I know that. So I need to provide 2 values for that row. I can print this and you can see the output. Okay. How can I delete a row? Just simply df.drop and df is the data frame name. And in that, provide the index of the row. Let's check it. Okay. So initially there were 3 rows, but now only 2 rows are present. So how can I delete multiple rows? Just give indexes like this. Okay. 0 and 2. There are 3 rows now. 0, 1 and 2 rows. Let's check it. Only row 1 is left out. Okay. How can I give row labels while creating data frame? It means row indexes. This is the data frame. You know how many rows? 3 rows. Okay. So just like columns, I can give index of rows. So for giving index of rows, I can use index and provide name here, right? How can I rename a row after creating the data frame? The data frame is created. Df.rename, provide index and row. You know this data frame will have 3 rows and by default the index of rows will be 0, 1 and 2. You have to create a dictionary. So the row index 0 will be converted into A, 1 index will be converted into B and 2 index will be converted into C. Okay, as you can see the output. Boolean indexing. Boolean indexing means giving true and false index to rows and columns. Okay, so how to give Boolean labels or index to rows? Similarly, like what we have done in our previous program, create a data frame. You know how many rows this data frame will have? 3 rows. Okay, because it has been created by using list and the list contains 3 internal lists, 3 items. So by default, you know, I have told you this shortcut, right? So I have created this data frame by using SD and I can give index like this, false, true, false, true, true, true. Okay, any index you want to give like this, false, true, false. I have given false, true, false. Print it, you can see the output. Row's name will be false, true, false, or I can say row labels. How can I display rows according to Boolean labels? First, I have created the data frame by using Boolean labels of rows. For selecting the rows according to a particular Boolean value, I can use LOC. DF, it is a data frame name, dot LOC. If I give false here, then all the rows those name is false will be selected. If I give true, then all the rows those name is true will be selected. How can I give Boolean values to column index? I have created a data frame by using row index as Boolean values, and I can give column index as Boolean values like this, df.columns, and provided a list of Boolean values. So the output is available in front of you. You know this data frame is created by using list, okay, and the list contain three internal lists. It means the list contain three items, so those three items will be used as rows. So this data frame consists of three rows and three columns. So I have given here three rows indexes, three column indexes. How can I print columns according to Boolean value? Simply create a data frame of Boolean values, column names, and then with the data frame name, put the square brackets, and in the square brackets, put the Boolean value. So the columns whose names are true will be selected. So this is our data frame, and I have given true. So columns of true names are selected. How can I display cells according to both Boolean index of row and column? Okay, so it means I was previously selecting a particular column of a particular row according to a Boolean value. Suppose I want to select particular cells according to Boolean value, then how can I do it? Firstly, create a data frame of column indexes and row indexes as Boolean value, and then here provide the column index and here provide the row index. I have taken true and true, so it means those rows that have true as a value will be selected, and those columns that has true as a value will be selected. It means firstly what I have given true column name, so you can select first column and third column, you can select these. Okay, but I have also given row value is true. So these are the our true value rows, so you know it will be selected. So cells that have rows and columns as true are selected. Okay, as you can see here. Now let's understand selection of rows in data frame by using ILOC and LOC. How can I select individual rows of a data frame? Create a data frame, and with the data frame name, give LOC and give the row index. Okay, so this data frame is created by using dictionary. So dictionary items will be created as column. So this data frame will have three columns, and column name will be 1, 2, and 3. So this data frame will have four rows, and the rows index will be by default 0, 1, 2, 3. So the third row index will be selected. Let's do it. So 8, 9, 8. It is selected, 8, 9, 8. Okay. How can I select sequence of rows? I can give it like this. Suppose I want to select rows whose indexes are 2, 3, and 4. So in the LOC, I can give indexes from 2, colon, 4. It means 2, 3, and 4 will be selected. I can also give step. So this data frame will have multiple rows. Okay. I am selecting rows from 1 to 6, and I am giving step of 2. It means 1, 3, and 5 rows will be selected. If I use ILOC, then what is the difference? If I use ILOC, every row will be selected, but not the last row. I am selecting rows 2, colon, 5, 2, 3, 4. Okay. I have used ILOC. That's why fifth row will not be selected. Fifth row means the row whose index is 5 will not be selected. I can also work it like this. I have not given any initial row index, but the ending row index I have provided, but I have used ILOC. So it means rows whose index are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be selected. Okay. Now, how I can use ILOC and LOC in series? So I have created a series here. This series will have how many rows? 7 rows. So I want to select rows 1, 2, 3 and 4. So I can use it like this. Okay, 1, 2, 3 and 4 rows will be selected. If I use ILOC, then only 1, 2 and 3 rows will be selected. I can also use a step like I have already used here. Okay, you can give step of 2, step of 3. Slicing. Slicing means selecting number of rows based on the range. It is similar to using LOC and ILOC. So this is a series. I have give a series name and I have selected rows from 2, 3 and 4. Remember, if I don't use LOC or ILOC, simply use the series name, then only all rows are selected, but not the ending index row will be selected. Okay, ending index row will not be selected. Slicing is same as ILOC. This and this will give me same output. Slicing in data frame. This is our data frame name and I have given here 2:6. So it means rows 2, 3, 4, 5 will be selected. Now let's understand selection of columns in data frame. Here we have learned how we can select rows based on a given range using LOC and ILOC. Okay. Now let's understand selection of columns. How I can select a particular column. Suppose this is our data frame. How many columns will this data frame consist? How many columns? Can you tell me? This data frame will consist 3 columns and how many rows? 7 rows. Suppose I want to select the column whose name is 2. Then with the dot LOC, give here nothing. Write colon here, give comma and the initial column name. Okay, I want to provide at both sides. Okay, and it will be used only for selecting a particular column. If I give 3 at both sides, then third column will be selected. How can I select a range of columns? Similarly, like the previous program, put colon, put comma, give the range 2:5. Okay, so all the columns whose names are 2, 3, 4 and 5 will be selected, as you can see in the program. Okay, this data frame is created by using a list. So list items will be considered as rows. So this data frame will have 5 rows. Row 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it means how many rows this data frame consists? 5 rows. And how many columns? Total 7 columns. But I have selected columns 2, 3, 4 and 5. I can also give step value. So according to the step value, the columns are skipped according to the step. What is the range here? 2:6. So 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 are selected. But I have given the step of 3. So 2 and 5 are selected. If I use ILOC, then the last mentioned column will not be selected. Right? So in that case, 2, 3, 4 and 5 are selected. Okay? Index 0 column. Index 1 column, you can see the values of the column. This is column 1, this is column 2. I'm talking about the index. So 2, 3, 4 and 5 are selected. 8, 9, 2, 3, 7, 8, 2, 5, as you can see here. Okay, ILOC will not select the last mentioned column. I can also give step. So how can I select multiple particular columns? Multiple columns. Put dot LOC. Provide here nothing before the colon. Okay, because we are working on the columns. Okay, put the comma and here you can give the column names that you want to select. Put the column names in the list. Series don't have selection in columns because the series has only one column. How can I select rows and columns simultaneously all together? So you can use it like this. Create a data frame, put dot LOC, 2:4, 2:5. It means select the rows that has indexes of 2, 3 and 4. Select the columns that has indexes 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, how can I save our data frame in a CSV file? Create a data frame and after that with the data frame name, put the dot notation and give 2_CSV function. And in this function, put R so that this address will be considered as a address, as a raw string. And here you can give any folder name, anywhere you can save it. I have saved it in C drive and in these folders. And after giving folder names, give data frame a name and put .csv. Okay. So in this location, df.csv will be created consisting of this data. How can I access content of a CSV file? Import pandas, take the address of CSV file, okay, and then apply function read underscore CSV, and in this function give the address of CSV file and print d, right? Concatenation means adding multiple data frame, okay, by default row wise, okay, and or we can concatenate by column wise. So how can we do concatenation? Add multiple data frame row wise. So you can see I have created two data frames. These data frames are creating by using list. So d1 data frame will have 3 rows and 3 columns. Similarly, d2 data frame will have 3 rows and 3 columns. Apply the function concat and put both data frames in a list. And if you want to ignore index, okay, then give it a value true. So as you can see, both the data frames are being added, okay, 31 12 67 31 12 67. This is the second data frame, this is the first data frame, both are added row wise. It means rows are increased, okay. I've given ignore index true. It means the upcoming data frame index rows will be according to the row index that is upcoming, okay. By default, the row indexes of the second data frame will be 0, 1 and 2, but those rows index are ignored, okay. If I don't give ignore index, then the default row indexes are used, 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. How can I concatenate column wise? For concatenating column wise, you have to give an additional argument here, that is axis 1, okay. So the columns will be increased. This is our first data frame, this is our second data frame. Columns are increased. 31, 12, 67, 67, 14, 98, 98, 34, 96. Okay. Second data frame. I have ignored index. So the default column index are not used here. If I don't use ignore index, then default column names are used. So we can add more than two data frames. Just put those data frames in the list. Mathematical operations in pandas. So let's understand these operations in series, okay. So these are two series. I can add two series, okay, or I can minus, divide, multiply, remainder, modulus, power, exponent, okay. So these are the mathematical operations. If I add two series, minus two series, okay, then what will happen? The values, okay, will be subtracted or added with each other. So I am adding here, it means 2 plus 6, 8. 8 plus 3, 11, 9 plus 4, 13, 9 plus 3, 12. You can see the output. A single series will be created by using mathematical operations, by applying these operations, as you can see here. We can also apply mathematical operations like this. For adding, we can put add, for subtracting, sub, div, multiplication, modulus, exponent, flow division. Here I am adding data frame A and B, data frame A and B like this, okay. We can also apply comparison operators like greater than, smaller than, okay, equal to, not equal to. So these are two series, and I'm creating a series of these comparison operators that will be telling me if A is greater than B. If the value of A is greater than B, it will give me true, otherwise it will give me false. So you know it, A is not greater than B here, so it has given me false. And both three values of A are greater than both three values of B, so these three values are true. We can also do mathematical operations like this in data frame. Just create data frame and apply the desired operation like addition, subtraction, etc. Like I have created the data frames here, and I can add them or subtract them. Okay, let me show you an example. So these are the two data frames, and I am adding them. Okay, so you can see I can also apply mathematical operation. I am checking equality. If any value is equal, it will give me true. So you can see only one value is found to be equal. Vector operations in pandas. Vector operation means if I apply any mathematical operation on a series, it will be automatically applied on all the objects of series. So this is the series, and I am adding an integer number with the series. So every value of the series will be incremented by 3, okay. But remember, the default values of the series will be remain unchanged. Only it will give me the change value. If I print A only in the fourth line, it will give me these values. Let's do it. Okay, this is the changed value and this is the default values of the series. I cannot add 3 in a list because list is a different data type and 3 is a different data type. Okay, only panda series support vector operations. So we can also do it like this. Okay, we can also apply mathematical and vector operations in data frame. I have already told you how you can apply mathematical operation in data frame. I have added 2 data frames here. You can see the output, and here I am applying vector operation with the data frame name. I am giving it an exponent of 2. So every value of the data frame will be shown by squaring. Okay, so 3 square, 9, 8 square, 64, and so on. So one thing that you must remember, if you are adding data frames, okay, applying any operation of like mathematical operation, adding, exponential, then column names must be same, right? So here this is the data frame AD, this is the data frame BD. So data frame AD has 2 columns, okay, and data frame BD has 2 columns A and B. You can simply visualize the structure of these data frame in your mind if you have watched this tutorial with focus, because I have told you how you can visualize the structure of a data frame. Okay, so while applying mathematical operation, must remember the data frame column names must be same, right? Students, I request you to subscribe our channel. Please support us. Okay, I have explained you all these topics very easily. Okay, so there are many other tutorials that are given in the description. You can watch them, and or you can visit our website topology.com and search for pandas topics. You can learn them very easily. See you there. Also invite your friends to our channel.